shadows. Your sword is useless here.
To do. Your father wants them to go away, and he only hurts me to silence them.
But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. They say that I'm already dead.
No,
they don't want me with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't
listen. Do you see them?
Do you see their faces?
She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started. Mother lost her smile. Her eye gazing past her towards a world she can see. This is what if you reach for the world. Dead. A lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt cold of fear. I don't talk much about her mother. Bell. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. That doesn't matter now, does it?
Come out. She can do it. She can't do it.
The light's gone out. Run! Get through it as quick as you can.
Stay, stay, stay. Get to the next light. Stay. Just go quick, run.
Rian the Dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rian would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother has the pieces, and so Rian is the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and go in search. The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly, it would be impossible to hit face to face. But Fafnir crossed the heath to find him. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all.
The torch is going out. She hasn't time. Burn out. She's too slow. It's not going to burn out. The darkness will come again. Reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a young girl. The faces in the dark, coming through the walls. She once thought everyone could see them. I mean, that's what children do all the time, isn't it? There are monsters. By the time she realizes her father, Zinbel, could see the monster in her.
searching for weakness. It found your mother and used her to trap you in here.
Did you see her die? I don't remember. I was only 5. They told me she escaped the darkness, that she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here?
It's a trap. The beast is coming. Stupid baby.
Spreading. Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Dylan.
Take him down. you! Behind you! Ignore the pain. Focus now!
Okay, that's all of them. Sweet.
It's nearly over. Finish it.
I'm gonna give my torch and fight again. R. Alright. This way is blocked. Oh, no. Not necessarily. Oh. Looks like there's something over here that I can look at. Go to the other side. Hopefully I can go up here as well. Nope. Oh, there it is. You killed us. You killed us. There it goes. There goes my light. No, he didn't. Her dad was a dick.
He's doing his best. She never listens. Didn't she listen to him? Trying to help her.
He was trying to save her from the darkness.
Zimbel was right. Zimbel was trying to save her from the darkness.
I don't believe that for a second.
But she wouldn't listen.
Never choose
it. And now.
Although Sigurd kills the dragon, Rian wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rian also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart friend. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby. Sigurd's newfound power lets him hear the birds speak, and they say, Sigurd should eat the heart himself. Rian wants Fafnir's gold. Kills Rian, eats Fafnir's roasted heart, and takes Fafnir's treasure. And he embarks on a new quest to ride the Hundredfell and find.
Well, time to run.
The Valkyrie.
Oh. Yeah, okay. That didn't help. Am I supposed to go in there and then look at the thing? Or am I supposed to go in and go right? I'm probably to die. Okay, I made it. Yay! It's in there somewhere. Huh. I'm probably about to die. I mean, it's light right there, so I don't know why I can't just go in there. Huh.
Sigurd's newfound power lets him hear the birds speak, and they say Sigurd should eat the heart himself. Rian wants Fafnir's gold. Sigurd should kill Rian before Rian kills him. Sigurd should find Brynhild the Valkyrie, who sleeps an enchanted sleep. Sigurd heeds the bird's advice. He kills Rian, eats Fafnir's roasted heart, and takes Fafnir's treasure. And he embarks on a new quest. To ride to Hinderfell and find Brynhild, the Valkyrie.
Can't help but think of him. A tender guiding flame in a world so black.
Okay.
The longer it burned, the more she convinced herself that there was nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
Only a man who knew no fear would ever reach her. But like me, Sigurd is fearless. And passes through the flames, just as I did, and wakes the sleeping warrior girl. She teaches him the secret wisdom of runes, namely victory runes, ship runes, runes for persuasion, runes for truth, runes for healing and help, runes for perception and power. Like Sigurd, the greatest young warrior of the North, you must learn the secrets of the runes to fight amongst the gods in hell.